Hello, my dear students. Hope you all are doing well. I welcome you all for your English online class. Children, kindly follow the below mentioned instructions. Use earphone or headphone for a better learning experience. Keep a notebook and a pen handy to make notes. Read the text on the screen. Sit at a quiet place. You may pause the video till you get ready to resume or when you have to make a note of important points. Students, topic for today is chapter number 2.5, Learn Yoga from Animals. Now, what is yoga? Yoga is a culture of physical, mental, spiritual discipline. It composite practice involving the complete mind, body, soul complex. It is an integrated system of physical exercises. Let's read the paragraph and understand this chapter more in detail. Children, kindly pay attention. Since the year 2015, the world has been celebrating June 21st as International Yoga Day. As most of us will know, yoga is a culture of physical, mental and spiritual discipline perfected in ancient India. Yoga as an ancient Indian discipline is a composite practice involving the complete mind, body, soul complex that is a human being. Here, let us focus on yoga as an integrated system of physical exercises that help us to attain concentration, focus and also improve flexibility, balance and strength. From an ancient Indian discipline, let us move to a very contemporary area of research. Experts today are doing a wonderful job of drawing us into the world of biomimicry. In simple terms, bio means life and mimicry is to emulate. Basically, biomimicry is the science of solving human problems with solutions already present in the natural world. From this point of view, yoga is also a form of biomimicry where in typical asanas or poses, we emulate mountains, trees, fish, cats and so many more animals. This helps solve our problems brought on by day-to-day living such as stiffness and back pain, and allows us to feel physically vibrant and mentally sharp. Before we proceed further, here are a few basic precautions regarding yoga practice. If you are a beginner, you should start practicing yoga either in the presence of a yoga teacher or join class so that you learn the basics and the do's and don'ts of yoga. Asanas should be practiced in a clean, airy and well-lit room. The floor should be level. It is advisable to use a yoga mat. If it is not possible to practice indoors, you may practice on level ground outdoors. The best time to practice is in the morning before breakfast or in the evening before dinner. Some of the poses described below must be learned from an instructor before you attempt to practice them on your own. Let us look at a few well-known animals' poses in yoga. First is Bhujangasana. Bhujangasana is a beginner's pose. Bhujanga in Sanskrit means a cobra. Bhujangasana is a pose that resembles the posture of a cobra with raised head. This asana helps you tone the muscle of the back and strengthen your spine. It also benefits the chest and shoulders. Steps. Lie face down. Relax all the muscles completely so that you are completely at ease. Place your palms on the side just below your shoulders. Breathe in deeply as you slowly raise your head. Then smoothly raise the upper part of your body. Do not come up with a jerk. Let your movement be smooth and flowing. Come up slowly so that you feel the movement of the spine vertebra by vertebra. Curve the spine well. The navel must keep touching the ground. Hold the breath in this position to a count of 20, then come down slowly while you breathe out. Then start with you can repeat the process 6 times. Okay? Now second is Simhasana or Lion Pose. Simhasana or Lion Pose is a favorite with young people. In this asana, you assume the sitting position and facial expression of a lion. Although there may be number of steps, this pose really requires very little effort. Steps. Sit with your legs folded under you so that your toes are pointing straight behind and you are sitting on your heels. Keep your spine straight but as relaxed as possible. Close your eyes and focus your attention on the center of the forehead. In yoga, this point is often referred to as the third eye. Closing your mouth, touch your palate, roof of the mouth with your tongue. Take a deep breath through your nose while your tongue is still touching your palate. Exhale in one strong move while sticking out your tongue and opening your jaws as much as possible. Also, your arms should be thrown out and stretched with your fingers splayed. Understood, children? Okay. Roar at the top of your voice while exhaling. The roar should be with a ha sound and should not be a long drawn out one. Rather, it should be one strong explosion of breath that empties your lungs in the shortest time possible. Hold this pose for between 20 to 30 seconds. Do not inhale immediately after this pose. Inhale after a few seconds. This asana or posture gets its name from the way you stick your tongue out as far as possible and the way you hold your fingers played out, resembling a roaring lion. Now children, first let's understand the meaning of difficult words present in this passage. So we will end here only. We will learn today only two asana, children. First one was Bhujangasana. Bhujangasana. Okay. Then second one was Simhasana. So the meaning of difficult words are culture. So your culture means combination. Composite means made up of different things. Integrated means united or combined. Flexibility means the quality of bending easily without breaking. Contemporary means living or occurring at the same time. Biomimicry means the science of solving human problems with solutions already present in the natural world. Emulate means imitate. Stiffness means inability to move easily. Vibrant means full of energy and life. Posture means the position in which you hold your body while sitting or standing. Tone, ear means firmness of muscle. Navel means belly button. Assume, ear assume means take. Splayed means spread out. Okay, so children, let us understand this more in detail. Okay, so here the author says, since the 2015, the world has been celebrating June 21st as International Yoga Day. Yoga helps us relieve tension and stress, and it is a combined system of physical exercises that help us to attain concentration, focus, and also improve flexibility, balance, and strength. Experts today are doing a wonderful job of drawing us into the world of biomimicry. In simple terms, bio means life, and mimicry is to emulate or imitate. Okay? Yoga is also a form of biomimicry, wherein typical asanas or poses, we imitate mountains, trees, fish, cats, and so many more animals. This helps us solve our body problems like stiffness and back pain. So the asanas are as follows. Bhujangasana. What is Bhujangasana? Bhujangasana in Sanskrit means a cobra. Theek hai? It is also known as a cobra stretch. This asana helps you tone the muscle of the back and strengthens your spine. It also benefits the chest and shoulders. See, children, can you see the image? This is the image of Bhujangasana. Lie face down. Can you see? I have given you one image is giving you the complete position of Bhujangasana, and the other images is showing you stepwise. See, lie face down, relax all the muscles completely so that you are completely at ease. Can you see number one? Left hand side of the slide. Okay. Then place your palms on the side just between your shoulders. Can you see? Image number two. Okay. Then breathe in deeply as you slowly raise your head. Can you see? Posture number three. Yeah. Then smoothly raise the upper part of your body. That is posture number four. Okay. Do not come up with a jerk. Let your movement be smooth and flowing. That is what is showing in posture number five. Okay, children. Come up slowly so that you feel the movement of the spine vertebra by vertebra. Curve the spine well. The navel must keep touching the ground. See posture number five. Okay. Now hold the breath in this position to a count of 20. Then come down slowly while you breathe out. Okay, you have to hold your breath, children. Okay, so to start with, you can repeat the process 6 times. Okay, when you're starting this yoga, you can start it with 6 times. Okay, now second is Simhasana. It is also known as lion pose. So what is it? Simhasana or lion pose is a favorite with young people. In this asana, you assume the sitting position and facial expression of a lion. Although there may be a number of steps, This pose really requires very little effort. Can you see the pose, children? Okay. Can you see both the images? Okay, so pay attention while I'm reading it for you. Sit with your legs folded under you so that your toes are pointing straight behind and you are sitting on your heels. Okay? Keep your spine straight but as relaxed as possible. Close your eyes and focus your attention on the center of the forehead. In yoga, this point is often referred to as the third eye. Okay. Close your mouth, touch your palate, roof of your mouth with your tongue. Take a deep breath through your nose while your tongue is still touching your palate. Exhale in one strong move while sticking out your tongue and opening your jaws as much as possible. Also, your arm should be thrown out and stretch with your fingers splayed. Roar at the top of your voice while exhaling. The roar should be with a ha sound and should not be among drawn out one. Rather, it should be one strong explosion of breath that empties your lungs in the shortest time possible. Hold this pose for between 20 to 30 seconds. Okay. So children, here comes the home assignment. I've given you only one question and the two sub-questions are: list steps of the below mentioned asanas. Bhujangasana, I repeat, it is Bhujangasana, Simhasana or Lion Pose. So you have to list the steps for Bhujangasana also and Simhasana also. Okay. So here comes the most important part of our lecture. We all want to speak English fluently. So we have adopted two activities, that is one is spoon feeding and another is quite challenging. But believe you me, children, once you have adopted this activity, you are no way far in speaking good English. So let's discuss the words. Integrated means united or combined. Emulate means imitate. Splayed means spread apart. So you need to frame sentences for the word integrated, emulate and splayed. Clear? Okay. So we are done with the lecture, children. In our next lecture, we will learn the same chapter 2.5, Learn Yoga from Animals, textbook page number 39. Thank you so much, my dear students, for your time and attention. Stay healthy, stay safe. God bless you all. Take care. Bye-bye.